possessions and safety is a big issue, and everybody wants to be safe and they want their possessions taken care of. Right now, most of the homeless people use shopping carts to house their possessions, and I believe that with this initiative between the Metro, the RCMP, and UBCO developing these carts, you'll get away from the shopping carts around town, and they can pack their personal items within these carts. In conjunction with the RCMP, the Metro, they brought the idea to UBCO, and UBCO came on board, and here we are a year later, and we have concept carts being designed by the students.
The full basically cycle of design in engineering starts from the conceptual design, then it moves to the trade-off design, and eventually to the detailed design. So in this project, we are lucky, and at the same time it's challenging, that we have to kind of carry on all these steps. So our first year design course students working more on the conceptual design part, whereas our fourth year capstone project and some of the graduate students taking those ideas started looking at the trade-off part of the design. And down the road, I can see very nicely this will come together and we will move towards more kind of finalizing the design option going to the actual production.
Our capstone project is based on helping out the homeless community by building a personal belongings carrier, a replacement for the shopping carts that they usually have.
This project was part of our first year design course, ASPC 171. This was a challenge put forward by a variety of organizations to create a cart which could be used for homeless people to facilitate their lives, and also to get away from the traditional shopping cart, just because it's a little bit of a messy setup. It also would allow us to integrate features such as an electrical generator for a lockable storage, just anything we could do to really improve the quality of life out on the streets. It's a really cool project to work on because it allows us to have so much freedom of design. It allowed us to do things that we wanted to play with. So we'd have an idea, we'd jot it down on the whiteboard, we'd kind of come up with a different way of solving the problem, design our entire interior around how we thought would be best. And we can still use traditional manufacturing techniques. It's just about how we're able to put it forward.
I think it's just a great opportunity to give back in terms of it, and we're not just doing something for our own experience. So it's something that you can actually see help the community.
Because everyone taking really a sense of pride of this, and given that we have several parties involved in this, not only at UBC but from outside, so helping all the way from our undergrad students, graduate students, and faculty members to get involved in different stages of the design and production and make this work.